Thank you. New tonight, a family in Eagle Point is looking for answers from the city regarding an intersection they claim is dangerous. Now they've started a petition to create change. NBC5's Anthony Carter spoke with the woman behind the effort. He's live in studio now. Anthony.
Anna, the family says this all started about a month ago when a car was involved in a high-speed chase. It crashed into their mobile home, seriously injuring one of the family members. Now, as momentum is building from the community in support of making the area safer, the family is hoping the city will hear them.
So intense. It was such a huge impact.
Michelle Schmidt and her family continue to wake up uneasy and on edge. They say a car that was traveling at a high rate of speed during a police chase crashed into their mobile home at Idlewood Park in the early Sunday morning hours of April 18th.
It woke us up from a dead sleep, and I have shelves in my bedroom and big long shelves, and they came down and hit me in the head.
The impact detached the home and knocked their father-in-law unconscious. Schmidt says he was later diagnosed with a concussion and is still afraid to even be inside.
There's no protection at all, and it could happen again, and it scares me.
Idlewood Park is located on the 400 block of Stevens Road, an area the family says cars speed by all of the time. They're pushing the city to reduce the speed limit. Schmidt says there used to be protection for the homes located on the corner. Now, she says people are nervous to walk on that side.
Once they redid the road, they took out the boulders, which leaves this home and our home susceptible.
Days after the crash, the family says the city's public works director agreed to place a barrier in front of the home. She says the plan changed.
They're not going to do it because he feels like it's a liability for the city of Eagle Point.
Schmidt's now gathering signatures from nearby residents to get the city to fix the situation. She has about 90 signatures so far.
We're hoping to get enough petitions to where they'll listen to us and do something about it before somebody gets killed, because it's just a matter of time.
Now, her father-in-law says he had to dump his entire life savings into a new mobile home. Late this afternoon, we reached out to the Eagle Point Public Works Director for comment on the situation. We have yet to hear back. Live in studio, Anthony Carter, NBC5 News.